Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn Geography, Chapter 1, Earth in the Solar System. This is a photograph of the sky at night. If you live in a city, the chances are that you might never have seen such a star-spangled night sky. But this is what the sky actually looks like on a clear moonless night, away from the lights of the city. The bodies you see in the sky from the earth are called heavenly bodies or celestial bodies. This includes the stars, planets, comets, and the moons. Let us find out more about these heavenly bodies one by one. Stars. The twinkling spots of the light that we see in the sky at night are called stars. There are billions and billions of stars in the universe. They are huge balls of very hot gaseous matter. They are self-luminous celestial bodies that emit heat and light. The sun is the star nearest to the earth. Now let us learn how the stars are formed. Stars are formed from huge clouds of dust and gas. When the center of the cloud becomes thicker and denser, it starts shrinking into a thick disk and starts spinning rapidly. You can see in the picture, the center of the spinning mass becomes hotter and hotter. Finally, a chain of reactions occur where huge amounts of energy in the form of heat, light, and other radiations are released into space, and a star is formed. The constellations. When seen from the Earth, some of the stars in the sky appear to be arranged in recognizable pattern. You might have seen when you go to your terrace at night, especially the children, they can see more number of pattern there. Some look like animals, some look like people, and some look like objects. These group of stars appear to make patterns in the sky are called constellations. The Sun. The Sun is almost 5 billion years old. The gravitational field of the Sun holds the entire solar system together. The Sun is made up of hot gases, mainly helium and hydrogen. The sun is the primary source of heat and light for living being on Earth. Life on Earth is possible because of its optimum distance from the sun. That is, the Earth is neither too far from the sun nor too close to it. Sunlight reaches the Earth in about 8 minutes. The surface temperature of the sun is 5700 degrees Celsius. You can imagine how hot this is when we say that the heat from the sun after traveling 149 million kilometers is still strong enough to give the heat to the earth. The next class we'll learn more about the planets, the earth, and the moon in the solar system. I have asked you a few questions about these. You can read the lesson once again, then answer. So till then, keep revising, keep studying. Thank you.